Hello students, I hope so everyone are good and safe. In today's video, we are going to see population dynamics last part. First, we are going to see underpopulation. In our last video, we saw overpopulation. In this video, we are going to see underpopulation. When the population of an area is less than the available resources of that area is called underpopulation. So what is underpopulation? The population of an area is less than the available resources of that area is called underpopulation. So what are the available resources? Like water, natural vegetation, all these are available resources of that area. So compared to population, the water and other resources are less, then it is known as underpopulation. The cause of underpopulation are decrease in birth rate, increase in death rate, and migration of people out of the area. So what are the causes of underpopulation? In birth rate, decrease in death rate, and migration of people from people out of the area. Then we are going to see the impacts. There is no congestion or overcrowding. So all these are positive impacts. So there is no congestion or overcrowding. There is less pressure on natural resources. Hence, environmental degradation is low. There are enough job opportunities for the people and thus low level of poverty. So there is no congestion or overcrowding in underpopulation. The positive impacts are there is no congestion or overcrowding, less pressure on natural resources. So there is less pressure on natural resources. Hence, environmental degradation is low. So why there is less pressure on natural resources? Because the environmental degradation is low. There are enough job opportunities for the people, thus low level of poverty. So in underpopulation area, there are enough job opportunities for the people. Next, we are going to see the negative impacts of underpopulation. What are those? We will see. There is shortage of labor. So, underpopulation, there is shortage of labor. The shortage of labor hampers the production of goods and services. So, the shortage of labor hampers the production of goods and services. The standard of living remains low. So, in underpopulation area, the standard of living remains low. There is underutilization of available resources. So, there is underutilization of available resources. At times of war, an underpopulated country might find it difficult to mobilize enough people to defend it. So, what are the negative impacts? Shortage of labor, production of goods and services, standard of living remains low, then underutilization of available resources. Then the last point is, during the war, the underpopulated country find it difficult to fight against the enough people who have a more number of people in war. Next, we are going to see is change of population. So, first we saw underpopulation, then we saw positive impacts and the negative impacts. Now, we are moving to the change of population. The change of population means the change in the number of people living in an area during a specific time, say a decade. So the change of number, the change of population means the change in the number of people living in an area during a specific time, say a decade. Decade means 10 years. It can be expressed either in absolute numbers or in percentage. So change of population can be expressed either in absolute numbers or in percentage. Then The change of population depends upon three factors. What are those? Birth rate, death rate, and migration. So, change of population means the change in the number of people living in an area during a specific time. So, the next is, the change of population can be expressed either in absolute numbers or in percentage. Next, what are the main factors of a change of population? Yes, birth rate, death rate, and migration. So, factors affecting change of population is birth rate, death rate, and migration. The number of births per 1,000 in a year is known as birth rate. So, now we are going to see the birth rate and death rate. The number of births per 1,000 persons in a year is known as birth rate. What is a birth rate? Yes, so number of live births per 1,000 persons in a year is known as birth rate. Next, the number of deaths per 1,000 persons in a year is known as death rate. So, the number of deaths per 1,000 persons in a year is known as death rate. The difference between birth rate and death rate in a year gives the annual growth of rate of population. So, what gives the annual growth rate of population? The difference between the birth rate and death rate. So, what is the birth rate? Number of live births per thousands in a year is known as birth rate. Then, what is a death rate? Number of deaths per 1,000 persons in a year is known as death rate. So, the difference between the birth rate and death rate in a year gives the annual growth of population. If the number of birth exceeds the number of death within a year, the population will increase. If the number of deaths exceed births within a year, then the population will decrease. So, here what they are telling, the first point, the number of births exceed the number of deaths. So, if we take per year, if the birth rate is high, then compared to death rate, then there will be increase in population. So, in a year, if the birth rate is higher than the death rate, then there will be increase in population. The next point they are telling, if there is an increase in death rate, then compared to birth rate, then it is population will decrease. So, if death rate is exceed than the birth rate, then the population will decrease. The movement of people from underdeveloped to developed areas are from the country to another with the intention to settle at the place of destination is called migration. So, what is migration? The movement of people from underdeveloped to developed areas are from the country to another with the intention to settle. So, with what intention they are coming from, they are moving from one place to another to settle at the place of destination is called migration. Next, we are going to see is composition of population. The composition of population refers to the structure of the population. So, the composition of population refers to the structure of the population. Age, sex, literacy, and composition are some components of population components. These components vary greatly from country to and from time to time. So, what is the composition population? The composition of population refers to the structure of population. So, what does composition of population refer? It refers to the structure of the population. What are the components of composition population? Age, you know all. Sex is gender. Then literacy and occupation are some of the components. Then these components vary greatly from country to and from time to time. So these components vary from country and from time to time. Next is rural and urban. On the basis of the place of residence, the population can be classified into two types. They are rural population, urban population. So on the basis of place of residence, the population can be classified into two types. So how they are classifying the population? By rural population and urban population. First, we will see the rural population. The people who live in villages are called the rural population. So, what is rural population? The people who live in villages are called the rural population. About 40% of the total population in the world live in villages. So, which percent is higher? Urban. Yes, so in rural population, they are only 40% of the total population in the world. Urban population. The people who live in towns and cities are called urban population. Who live in towns and cities are called urban population. So, for rural, just imagine your native place or your favorite villages. Okay, then for urban, Madurai, Chennai, all these are cities, towns and cities. So Chennai is a city, so it is a urban area. So like that, they have divided rural and urban separately. So about 54% of the total population of the world live in towns and cities. So what is a rural population? People who live in villages are called rural population. Then only 40% of the total population in the world live in villages. So how many percent is there? 40%. Then urban population. People who live in towns and cities are called the urban population. So how many percent is here? 54% of the total population of the world live in towns and cities. Next is age composition. Age composition refers to the number of people in each age group. So what does it refer? It refers to the number of people in each age group. So for example, the number of people in the age group 0 to 4 years, 5 to 9 years and so on. So generally, the population of a country is broadly divided into children 0 to 4 years, adult 59 years, and age 60 years and above. So what is age composition? Age composition refers to the number of people in each age group. So age composition refers to the number of people in each age group. For example, the number of people in the age group such as 0 to 4 years, 5 to 9 years and so on. So generally, the population of a country is broadly divided. So how they are dividing the population? By the years. So if they take children, they will say 0 to 4 years, how many of them are there in the country? Then if they take adults, they will see from 15 years to 59 years, how many of them are there in the country. Then if they take aged means 60 years and above. So like that, they will divide it into three and they will see the age composition. Population pyramid, also known as age-sex pyramid, is useful to understand the composition of population of any country. So population pyramid is useful to understand the composition of population of any country. It is a graphical representation which shows the distribution of females and males in different age groups. So what does population pyramid show? It shows the distribution of females and males in different age groups. If the death rate as well as the birth rate are high, then the population pyramid is broad all the base and tapering towards the top. So the death rate as well as the birth rate are high. Death rate and birth rate are high, then the population pyramid is broad all the base and tapering towards the top. Next is, if the birth rate and the death rate are low, then the population pyramid is narrow at the base. So if the birth rate and death rate are low, then the population pyramid is narrow at the base. The population pyramid shows that the decrease in death rates allow more people to reach old age. Here, what it shows, the population pyramid shows that the decrease in death rates allow more people to reach old age. It shows due to decrease in birth and death rates, the base of the pyramid has become less broad. So it shows due to decrease in birth rate and death rate, the base of the pyramid has become less broad. So by now, we come to an end, children. So the population dynamics, we have completed the lesson. Now, in today's video, we saw underpopulation, positive impacts and negative impacts. Then we saw about rural and urban population is, so how many percent are there in urban? 54. Then how many percent are there in rural? 40. Yes, very good. Then we saw about age composition. Yes, we saw in detail about pyramid population. So children, in GCR I will post the questions for you all, and I want everyone to attend it.